Hey guys, and welcome to Moto Chat. My name is Luke, and I'm here today to review what's behind me. This is a Nissan Micra from 2000. It's 23 years old, this car. Okay, it's only done, however, 53,000 miles. It's a very old car, but we're gonna see if it's just as capable as some of the cars we see on the road today. Let's find out. Things you start to notice about the little Nissan Micra is the fact that it's got dents, it's got knocks, and it's got scratches. It's an old car, it's been around for almost a quarter of a century, but it's still on the same roads doing the same job that it did when it came out the factory, and it's still just as capable as some of the big cars that you see in the city today. Another fantastic feature on this car is the fact that it uses an actual key. I mean, this is a rarity when you see this on actual cars these days, because most of them just use a stupid dongle. If you pop the key in, turn it, voila, the door opens and you can get in and start the engine. One of the characterful things about this car is the door doesn't actually shut properly. So when I pull it, you can hear a slight clonk, and that's because the door is actually lower than the frame of the door. So you can hear it clonk like that. Let's start the actual engine now. So you put the key in and you start it. And you get two nice big blaring red lights on the dash, which is lovely to see. Very reassuring. It's time to actually try and drive this car now. So I've knocked it into reverse, well, now I have, and the car has made a reassuringly silent noise. Take the handbrake off, and away we go. I must say, one thing that is particularly nice about this car is it is so, so small. You can get through really small roads. If you live in Cornwall, you know, the Cornish countryside, those little narrow lanes, you can get straight down there, not a problem. It can get into small car spaces. It can just go around town. It uses next to no fuel. It's cheap to tax, cheap to insure, and it's just good fun. It's a really fun little car to drive. So driving this car around, you do start to notice little telltale signs that the car is 23 years old. You know, it hasn't got a rev counter, it's only got a speedometer, which arguably is the dial you need the least in this car because it is so slow. Also, you are about 2 millimeters away from the tarmac, which is a little bit dangerous on the M6, to say the least. And you get some interesting looks from people on the side of the road because you are driving a car that is so old that it turns heads. As well as those little niggly things, it also is bloody hot in here. It is absolutely boiling, and there's no aircon, because Nissan thought, why should we splurge out on a car that is really cheap? No, let's not add any aircon at all, so that the driver boils to death. Also, the gear changes in this car, the ratios between the gears are very, very close together. So if you're trying to, say, shift between first and, I don't know, second, it takes only a millimeter of space, which is potentially a good thing, but you can also accidentally change to fourth without realizing it, which does present some minor issues. Just a few. Right, positives, positive things about the Nissan Micra, positive things, come on. It's small, oh no, I've already said that. It's small. It doesn't use a lot of fuel. I've already said that as well, haven't I? And positive things, come on car, what's good about you? Speed bumps are a thing. And let me tell you, in this car, they do feel like 10,000 feet cliffs that you've got to try and get over. They are quite high and they do sort of throw you out your seat a little bit. Okay, I can give the Micra a little bit of speed now. So what I'm gonna do, I'm engaging fourth, and I'm pressing down hard on the pedal. Come on! 45 miles an hour. That's a number.
Unfortunately, the Micra was so infuriatingly slow that I had to rock back and forth to make it go a little bit quicker.
It doesn't seem to want to drive this car. It doesn't seem to like the road as such. It's just like, eh, eh. Okay, another corner here, blind corner, indicating. Well, the indicator stalks are on the left-hand side, which is useful. Oh my God! Yeah, it's a bit dangerous. It's a bit dangerous, this car. A little bit dangerous. I wouldn't buy it if you were, say, a first-time buyer. stay away from this one.
I have thought of one positive about this car, and that is the fact that it does have character. It's an old car, it doesn't look like every car on the road, which is good, and yeah, it's got quite a gaudy little happy face, and people like the look of it, generally. So if you like driving a bit of a quirky car, something a little bit offbeat, then maybe the Nissan Micra Celebration Edition is the car for you. The bumps are pretty bad. I have thought of one positive actually, another one. You also don't need to be scared of speed cameras, or let's say, policemen, because honestly, they're not gonna pull you over in a car that looks like this. In fact, they'll pity you. It is getting a bit too hot in here now. I am sort of boiling over a little bit. Another positive about the Micra, cars that were built in the 2000s were built to just be cars. That's all they did. And you could tinker with them, you could open the bonnet and you could tweak them. Cars these days, they are radios, they are smartphones, they are tablets, and they've got red tape everywhere. You can't even touch a car under the bonnet these days. So that's another positive. If you like tinkering with your cars, buy a classic. There's no synchros on the gears either, that's something to mention. And there's lots of strange little rattle noises coming from the backside that I'm not too sure are particularly reassuring. So there's that as well. What I'm gonna do now, I'm actually gonna attempt to park the Micra and do the parking test. So let's give it a go. Not bad. It's actually really easy to park this car, so that's not particularly entertaining, but it's true. So can't really complain about the little Micra. It got into that space nice and easily. It's such a small car, you can't really go wrong, to be honest. So there's another point to the Micra.
So there's another complaint about the Micra as well, just to add insult to injury, and that's the fact that this window winder here actually falls off the door when you shut it. Not brilliant. Let me show you. That is a quality item right there from Nissan.
Right, seatbelts on. It's time to draw this video to a close and give the Micra, let's say, a score out of 10, shall we, for practicality, and also, should you buy one in 2023? So, do I recommend the Nissan Micra for 2023? Well, the short answer is obviously no. I mean, it's an old car, it's 23 years old. You know, it's not going to be as safe as a big Nissan Juke with a lot of safety features. It's not going to be as reliable, you know? But is it fun? Yes. It only has 53 brake horsepower, but it feels like it's got more. You know, it's still got a lot of character, it turns heads. It's cheap to insure, it only weighs 835 kilograms. The list goes on and on. But it's an old car. You've got to weigh up in your head whether it's going to last you for the next few years. For me, I'll be sticking to my little Panda 4x4. But this has been Motor Chat, and I hope you've enjoyed the experience. Take care, guys. See you in the next one.